everybody. So you know what day it is, right? It is February 7th and it is the next weigh-in. I believe this will be the 6th weigh-in. And so, well, hopefully I did all right. We'll see here in just a few minutes, so stay tuned. Okay, so I've got really great news this week. And that really great news is, well, after 2 weeks of being stuck at the very same weight, I am proud to announce that is no longer the case. Last week I lost 1.2 pounds and 3/4 of an inch. So I'm pretty excited about that. So I was at 205 even for the last 2 weeks. My start weight was 212.4. So I've lost now over 8 pounds. I'm pretty stoked about that. Making progress. And now my total inches lost since I started my journey is 8.5. So I tend to stay pretty equal for the pounds lost and my inches lost. And I'm kind of curious if the same thing happens with you all. If it does, just leave a comment below because I'm kind of curious the weight and inches ratio to see if everyone else is kind of like happening the same way I am or if they're measuring that. But my chest was an area where I went down a little bit. The chest was 43.5 last week or this week, and my waist 40.5, so I lost another 1/4 inch there. My left arm 15, right arm 15, and my hips remain at 46, which is really weird. But my left thigh and my right thigh are now even at 29.5. The left calf 16.25, and the right calf is 16.75. Like I said, I'm pretty stoked because I had a couple of weeks where it just wasn't moving, it wasn't budging, and you know, I was even doing better on the Dr. Peppers and that kind of thing. So, but I still haven't eliminated them. Don't be fooled. I have not eliminated them. I may have had like 2 whole days total without a Dr. Pepper. So, yeah, still on the Dr. Pepper. Just not like I was. Not drinking as near as much Dr. Pepper that I had been drinking. So, the Red Diamond Tea, I'm seeing an effect there. It seems like that's working and helping adjust with the whole Dr. Pepper thing. And another thing that's really vital, I think, to this past week's success is I believe I had probably 4 out of 7 days where I was able to maintain very close to 1,500 calories. So that's me greatly reducing the calories. And I say around because it was in between usually 1,500 to 1,600 those 4 days. And the other days I wasn't at 2,000. Maybe one day I was at 2,000, but for the most part I stayed under the 2,000, like 1,800, 1,900. So that is a lot of progress, especially when I'm used to eating so much extra fast food and all that other stuff from working and being on the road and that kind of thing. It's just easy, but you know, my salads, all that, it's working, it's helping me. I mean, I'm starting to feel, you know, skinnier and that kind of thing. So I'm really, really stoked and really excited. I mean, this is phenomenal, phenomenal to me. Because I think the way that I'm doing this will be sustainable. Also, there's something else that I want to do. There's a lady out there, Obesetoolympian. From Obesetoolympian. And you know, she took the time out of her busy day and her own YouTube channel, and I just wanted to say I'm very grateful. You know, she acknowledged me, and so I want to thank everybody that she sent over also to my channel. Those kinds of things, you know, sometimes people think I'm always the one with a lot of words, but then sometimes when it comes to emotions, like, there's days I'll just say I'm fluid with my words, it's great, and then there's other days, like, I really struggle, like, trying to find the words, but truly means the absolute world to me. I love people, I love helping people, it brings me great joy. When they can benefit from, you know, my presence and what I have to offer and that kind of thing. So, Obesetoolympian, thank you so much. And if you guys aren't currently subscribed to her, please go check her out. I'll try to leave a link in the description to her channel, so you guys can go and pay her a visit. You know, she's going to have a great journey, and I'm very thankful and grateful that she's joining my on mine, as well as all of you. And I'm gonna say this too, make sure that you're please taking care of your skin during the process. You want to, you know, be kind to your skin. It's been kind to us, it dealt with us, you know, adding all of our extra flubber and growing with us and stuff. So do that. And I'm trying to improve my water intake. Make sure you're drinking plenty of water as well. And if you're thinking about starting your own weight loss journey, just go ahead and do it. It's great because it holds you somewhat accountable, you know, not only to others, but to yourself. If you lay out like a goal and you say, hey, I want to do this, I want to meet this goal, then, you know, by starting the journey and maybe documenting it, and maybe you don't necessarily want to show it where you upload on a regular basis or anything like that. If that's not something that you're comfortable with, a suggestion that I have that may work, and it's only a suggestion, you can do with it what you want. But the suggestion is this: maybe document it the whole entire time, however long it takes you to do it. And then you can, after it's all done and you've met your goal weight or where you're happy and satisfied, then you can share it. But it'd be pretty cool to be able to watch, you know, go back, at least watch yourself, and know how far you came to get where you went, or if, like, somehow, some way, around halfway, a quarter, whenever it happens, you start to doubt your journey or why you're doing it and you want to go back to the old way, just remember why you started it in the first place. And you're going to have the ups and downs, and it, you know, I'm in sales, so it's a very emotional job. And I mean, there's the ups, there's the real good highs, you know, and then there's, you know, the lows. And I'm always looking for the sunshine around the corner, or the yes around the corner, and that kind of thing. So, it's just a recommendation. I go out there and, like, try to research, find things, and, you know, I've seen it looks like that's what some people did. Or maybe they didn't document the whole process, and maybe they wish they had, I don't know, but, you know, they have at least the before and then the after, and then they kind of talk about how they did their weight loss transformation a little bit. But I think it's really important, and it's vital, and you hold a key, I believe, to helping other people. And it is a great risk to kind of put yourself out there. It takes a lot of courage. But once you start getting into it, I think it does a lot for not only the physique part and the health part, but I think it also does a lot for one's mental, and then I think it does a lot for your relationships as well. And so, you know, that's one of the things that I think about all the time, is how I'm gonna feel, you know, after I lose all this extra fat that I've allowed, you know, to acne under my skin. And what are some things that maybe that has prevented me from doing that I've wanted to do? And, you know, sometimes people's pain thresholds are, you know, really high. I would say probably like for physical pain, mine's pretty high, but there also gets to be a point where you're just tired and you're gonna finally make a change. And, you know, I'm definitely there. Like, I just don't want to have to deal with it anymore. I'm tired of, you know, it's hard to tie my shoes. Just little simple things, getting out of bed. I mean, you start to think about, boy, what did I take for granted whenever I, you know, didn't have all these extra roles to deal with. And so, anyways, I'm not going to complain anymore. And that's really not complaining. I'm just saying, hey, I look, you know, forward to being able to feel more comfortable in my skin when I go do things with my family. Like when we went to Walt Disney World, they felt fat, you know, and it's hard to take pictures when you feel fat and that kind of thing, which is ironic. I'm actually like videoing myself fat and talking to people fat and juggling around, jumping around, doing my exercises, and people can see my rolls flopping up and down and my shirt rolling up over my belly. But it's because I'm willing to make a change. And if I can help other people during my process, or like down the road after I've already met it and, you know, they're just starting their journey, and I can bring any benefit to them, it's great. It's worth it. And by the way, it's helping me along the way too. Because what I'm learning from you all and your support, that helps me. And then whatever I can give back, I will try my hardest to give back. But also in me talking about it, it's also how I'm learning and absorbing the information as well. So anyways, recap for the week. Down from 205 to 203.8. And total inches lost since I started my journey, 8.5 inches. And I'm just totally, totally happy about that. So the main thing is just to keep on doing what I'm doing. Try to keep the Dr. Peppers down. I mean, I would be probably doing a lot better if I just completely eliminate those suckers. Because when I go in there and put it in on my Fitness Pal thing, it tells me immediately, like, basically I'm over my sugar. And I'm like, that's the first thing I've inputted. So that deal is, yeah, helping me, because I can't tell myself the stories that got me in this situation in the first place anymore. That's one tool. And then I was talking to my oldest son about, I said, hey, you know, being fat or whatever, I can't do certain things. Like, I was like, you know, I'm sitting there and I'm doing the cardio kickboxing, and I really am not fond of that one. And I said, my legs, it just feels like I can't get them up anymore. And he goes, Mom, that's a story you're telling yourself. And I'm really glad, because, you know, you need that kind of accountability. And he said that it's the same for skinny people too. And he goes, I feel like I'm in pretty good shape. You know, and he just turned 20, and he's like, I feel like I'm in pretty good shape, but sometimes that happens to me too. You're wore out, whatever. But anyways, I am starting to feel like there's the changes in the inches, and starting to feel like my waist is a little bit trimmer. Like I'm getting kind of like the V shape back and that kind of thing. So I am totally excited about that. It's a really great feeling. But anyways, I don't want to take any more of your precious time, and I really do appreciate you taking the time out of your busy day, to send me kind words, lift me up. I will try to do the same for you as much as I possibly can, but I appreciate your support, appreciate you subbing and joining me on my journey. And there again, if you're thinking about one, go ahead and get started. You have nothing to lose but the fat. And you have everything to gain in your life. Everything to gain. From your personal, your relationships, your career, personal goals, and how you feel about yourself. Everything to gain from the journey. That's how wise people get wise. But anyways, thank you again. Take care. Until next time, I'll see you later. Bye-bye. Hey guys, it is February 8th. Wednesday, February 8th. And I actually went ahead and did the cardio kickbox burn. My battery died, and so I had to put it on the charger. So while that was happening, I went ahead and did the cardio kickbox burn, and I'm proud to announce, before I was just doing like the easy jumping jacks, which really weren't the jumping jacks, but it was like the prelude, however she teaches you to do the jumping jacks from an easier standpoint that's easier on your joints and that kind of thing. Well, today, whenever I went to the jumping jack section, I actually just started doing the crazy things. So I'm pretty proud of myself for that, because I could do it and I did the whole set. So I'm very, very stoked about that. Something's really cool tomorrow. It's our youngest birthday. So I got his balloons right here. See them right here. Got the cute little teddy bear balloon. The cool thing about having a February baby, you know, it's around Valentine's Day, which is pretty cool. And then of course the little happy birthday. He's becoming a teenager. This is my baby. But anyways, in the blue balloon. So in the morning when he wakes up, I'll have the balloons all out and everything for him. And I've been working on his cake. I had the oldest birthday on the 30th of January. So there's that, and working on a few other things. So it's pretty cool, because if he browses in here, it's all kind of covered up. So anyways, birthdays are always cool. So we'll do like the family birthday. You know, you got to have something for on their birthday. And I got a call today. You know, he's got something pretty cool on its way, something he's been kind of dreaming about for several months coming, and he's got to build it and put it all together, but it's pretty cool. And got a call confirmation on that, and then but now I gotta finish planning everything for him to have friends come over and have that actual kind of big birthday. So it's all cool and exciting times. So what I'm gonna do today, I think it's been a few days, but I think it'd be good, since I already did the cardio kickbox burn, that I go ahead and do the 2-minute sit-up challenge again. And if anybody can tell me how to put that timer thing on my TV, that'd be amazing, instead of me just relying on a cell phone. Yeah, there's some things I'm really good at, and there's things I don't want to mess with, and sometimes certain things of technology, I'm just like, blah, I don't want to mess with that. Other things, I'm like, that's intriguing. Sure, if it's going to help me be creative or whatever, sure, I want to learn that, whatever. But if anybody could just make that easy for me and tell me how to put, like, a timer thing on the TV screen, that would be amazing. And I would greatly appreciate that. So I'm going to go ahead and get everything set up and get ready and do the 2-minute setup challenge. Alright, so I'm getting ready to start the 2-minute setup challenge. I'm starting it now. So I got that done. Just completed the 2-minute sit-up challenge. And on to the next thing.
Okay, so for the next thing, it's been a while. I mean, I've been on the T-zone, but I mean, it's been a while since I've gone on here and... How did you come unplugged your T-zone? Are. That scared me there for a minute, T-zone. So it's been a little bit since I've been on the T-zone, at least on the videos anyway. And so while I'm on the T-zone, there's something that I kind of want to share with you guys. And you can let me know, you can leave in the comments if you don't like it. or if it's boring to you or whatever. But I thought that I would share a story. It's really short. I read some big books, but the ones that seem to be some of the most valuable books to me tend to be like 100 pagers. And this one happens to be by an author in the 1930s, during like the Great Depression period, but also a period where a lot of very successful people were born out of that Great Depression and that kind of thing. But this author, her name is Florence Scovel Shinn. I'm gonna start this on program 2. Hopefully it won't be too choppy for you. But the chapter that I'm gonna read is chapter 4 out of her book, The Secret Door to Success. And I think this is very, very important to share and to think about. But it says, "What do you expect? According to your faith be it unto you." Matthew 9:29. Well, faith is expectancy. According to your faith, be it done unto you. We might say, according to your expectancies, be it done unto you. So, what are you expecting? It's very important to visualize and what you expect, so it will manifest. So that's why you want to be positive and not negative, so you don't manifest negative things. But it says, we hear people say, we expect the worst to happen, or the worst is yet to come. They are deliberately inviting the worst to come. We hear others say, I expect a change for the better. They are inviting better conditions into their lives. Change your expectancies and you will change your conditions. That's absolutely true. I've experienced that myself. How can you change your expectancies? When you have formed the habit of expecting loss, lack, or failure, begin to act as if you expected success, happiness, and abundance. Prepare for your good. Do something to show you expect it to come. Active faith alone will impress the subconscious. If you have spoken the word for a home, prepare for it immediately, as if you hadn't had a moment to lose. Collect little ornaments, tablecloths, etc., etc. And I do challenge you to do that. Because it's funny, it happens. Like, you will manifest what you're doing as long as you practice these simple little things. I knew a woman who made the giant swing into faith by buying a large armchair. A chair meant business. She bought a large and comfortable chair, for she was preparing for the right man. He came. Someone will say, suppose you haven't the money to buy ornaments or a chair. Then look in a shop windows and link with them in thought. Or you might have heard of a vision board. put those things on a vision board. The house, a house that you would like to have, and other little trinkets and things like that to put in that house. Get in its vibration. I sometimes hear people say, I don't go into the shops because I can't afford to buy anything. That is just the reason you should go into the shops. Begin to make friends with the things you desire or require. I know a woman who wanted a ring. She went boldly to the ring department and tried on rings. It gave her such a realization of ownership that not long after, a friend made her a gift of a ring. You combine with what you notice. So have you ever noticed, like, whenever you go buy a car, and then all of a sudden you see that car everywhere, but you didn't notice it before? That's just kind of one of the probably easiest ways to kind of lay that out. Or you've thought about a car, a certain car, for a really long time, and then all of a sudden one day you're like, I'm driving that car. That's kind of how that works. Keep on noticing beautiful things, and you make an invisible contact. Sooner or later, these things are drawn into your life, unless you say, poor me, too good to be true. My soul, wait thou only upon God, for my expectation is from Him. This is the most important statement from the 62nd Psalm. The soul is the subconscious mind, and the psalmist was telling his subconscious to expect everything directly from the universal, not to depend upon doors and channels. My expectation is from Him. God cannot fail. For His ways are ingenious. His methods are sure. You can expect any seemingly impossible good from God if you do not limit the channels. Do not say how you want it done or how it can't be done. God is the giver and the gift and creates His own amazing channels. Take the following statement. And this could be an affirmation that you can put up on a wall, put in your car, and say every morning when you wake up and before you go to bed. But here you go. I cannot be separated from God the giver. Therefore, I cannot be separated from God the gift. The gift is God in action. Get the realization that every blessing is good in action, and see God in every face and good in every situation. This makes you master of all conditions. A woman came to me saying that there was no heat in the radiators in her apartment and that her mother was suffering from the cold. She added, the landlord has declared that we cannot have heat until a certain date. I replied, God is your landlord. She said, that's all I want to know, and rushed out. That evening, the heat was turned on without asking. It was because she realized that the landlord was God in manifestation. This is a wonderful age for people who are becoming miracle-minded. It is in the air. Quoting from an article which I found in the New York Journal and American by John Anderson, it collaborates what I have just said. The title of the article is, Theater Goers Make Hits of Metaphysical Plays. If, said a cynical manager who shall be called Brock Pemberton, with a slight accent of sarcasm in his voice. The other night, on an intermission curbside talk, you fellows, meaning the critics, know so much about what the New York public wants. Why don't you tell me what to produce? Why don't you run me into business instead of out of it? Why don't you tell me what sort of play the playgoers want to see? I would, I said, but you wouldn't believe it. You're hedging, he said. You don't know, and you're trying to cover up by pretending to know more than you're willing to say. You haven't any more idea than I have this minute what sort of plays generally succeed. I have, I said, there is one sure-fire success. One theme that works and has always worked. Whether it is competing with boy meets girl, mysteries, historical tragedies, etc., no play on the theme has ever completely failed. if it had any merit at all. And a lot of poor ones have been big hits. You're stalling again, said Mr. Pemberton. What sort of plays are they? Metaphysical, I said, fouling slightly with a big word and waiting quietly for the effect. Metaphysical, said Mr. Pemberton. You mean metaphysical? I paused a moment, and since Mr. Pemberton said nothing, went right on spouting such titles as The Green Pastures, The Star Wagon, Father Malachi's Miracle, etc. Some of these, I added, reached the public over the heads of the critics, but Mr. Pemberton had departed to ask probably in every theater in town, is there a metaphysician in the house? People are beginning to realize the power of their words and thoughts. They understand why faith is the substance of thing hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. We see the law of expectancy working out through superstition. If you walk under a ladder and expect to give you bad luck, it will give you bad luck. The ladder is quite innocent. Bad luck came because you expected it. We might say expectancy is the substance of things hoped for, or expectancy is the substance of thing man fears. The thing I expected has come upon me. Nothing is too good to be true. Nothing is too wonderful to happen. Nothing is too good to last. When you look to God for your good. Now think of the blessings which seem so far off and begin to expect them now. Under grace in an unexpected way, for God works in unexpected ways. His wonders to perform. I was told that there are 3,000 promises in the Bible. Let us now expect all these to come to pass. Among them we are promised riches and honor, eternal youth, your flesh shall become as a little child's, and eternal life. Death itself shall be overcome. Christianity is founded upon the forgiveness of sins and an empty tomb. We now know that all these things are scientifically possible. As we call on the law of forgiveness, we become free from mistakes and the consequences of mistakes. Though your sins be as scarlet, ye shall be washed whiter than wool. Then our bodies will be bathed in light and express the body electric, which is incorruptible and indestructible, pure substance expressing perfection. I expect the unexpected. My glorious good now comes to pass. So this wasn't to be a Bible study or anything like that. But one of the things that is true about this is what you put out there, what you expect, is what you will get. So if you expect somebody to be mean to you, they will be mean to you. If you expect somebody to be good to you, they will be good to you. It's all about a mindset. If you want to meet a goal or anything, as long as you put your mind to it and you put faith into it and you work for it, in whatever way that is, it will come. There will be days that you feel like you're not going to meet it, but I tell you what, a lot of times it's when you feel like you're not going to meet the goal or whatever it is that you want, and you feel like you're in a dark room all by yourself, you will find that is the test. And if you stick with it and you stick through it, sunshine's just right around the corner. And that's what I wanted to leave you with today. Maybe it was heavy, I don't know. But this is a chapter that I go back to every once in a while. And if you like this, let me know, and I will share more great little things like this that I know that's helped me obtain some of the things that I've wanted to obtain in my personal life, my career, helping people out. So anyways,